Okay, yesterday you learnt about what CCI is, what are the different elements is, what its formula is. Okay, now today let me talk to you about the default period. CCI has a default period of 20. Why is it 20? Why, I mean, when you look at it, you think 20 is too long. So why should it be 20? Why not less? You know, it's 20 because number one, it takes the pivot point per candle, okay, which means it slows down the price movement, right? Number two, it takes the 20 period moving average, simple moving average of the pivot point, which further slows it down. And then it checks when the pivot point breaks over its own 20 SMA, right? So one is an average, second is an average of an average. Therefore, 20 periods is perfectly fine. It gives you very good signals. Do not think about reducing it. Now, let me show you an example. Okay, now, typically when, let's assume this, whatever stock this is, it has got listed, you know, on day one. Okay, now, typically a CCI will not start showing up in the indicator panel till 20 periods are over. But here we are doing this for an example. So, I'm starting from period one. You can assume that there was a similar rotation earlier upstairs. Okay, so it starts at 890 and on the 20th period it ends at 1075. Okay, the 20 period SMA I have calculated and you can check it, you know, you can check it by going to the Excel sheet. I have calculated the difference out here, then I have taken the average of the 20 SMA of the difference out here and I have applied a formula and you know I got the denominator. This was the numerator here, that this is the denominator that I worked out, you know the formula, it's there on the Excel sheet, right? There I got the CCI 67, 103, 82, 122, 70, 33, 118, blah blah blah, it goes to 121. Okay, you can apply the formula and check for yourself. Where do you see a breakout? Okay, now the breakout that you see, typically when you go into theory, people say when it crosses over 100, it's a breakout. Okay, I would say that 70 is a good point for a breakout. And I'll explain to you with illustrations tomorrow when I make, or tomorrow or the day after when I make a video. So CCI can fluctuate in the plus zone, in the minus zone to any extent. So when it crosses above 70 plus, in my opinion, it's a bullish sign. And when it crosses below minus 70, it's a bearish sign. Right? These are the levels. So I'll now continue this in the next video and I'll go deeper into it. It's a real damn good indicator if you know how to work it. Okay, so bye for now. Thanks.